I direct the Human Power Lab, and POWER is an acronym that stands for the Physiology of Wearable Robotics. We're interested in how humans interact with robots that they wear on their legs. The ultimate goal is to build devices that people can wear on their legs to restore movement. We like to work with clinical populations, including stroke and spinal cord injury. We can use robotic devices to restore symmetry in their gait and hopefully reduce the amount of energy they use to move around in the world. The frames that we build that people wear, they're like carbon fiber boots, and we attach artificial muscles to them that act not much differently than the muscles that are underneath our skin. We use a lot of equipment in the lab that's state of the art, and we combine a lot of different technologies that other labs can't in order to learn things that other labs can't because they don't have the capabilities. One is a treadmill, which you can see behind me. It's basically an expensive bathroom scale. It has instruments underneath its belts that record the forces of a person's foot when they place it on the ground. And me, there are 8 cameras. They use infrared tracking, and we place reflective markers over key areas of the lower limbs that we're interested in understanding the movement of. And probably the most exciting thing we're doing these days is using ultrasound imaging to literally take a look under the skin at how muscle fascicles move, how they shorten and rotate when a person walks and runs.
What we wanted to do with this latest study was use the ultrasound imaging technique to take an under-the-skin look at what muscles are doing during healthy, ordinary locomotion. So the ultrasound probe was placed over one of the calf muscles, the medial gastrocnemius here, which is a really important muscle for powering walking. And what that allowed us to do was see how that muscle is behaving when we were walking at different speeds and then running as well.
So our main focus right now is on devices that you wear on an already existing limb. However, the technologies we develop in terms of the actuators, so the motors, the spring and motor combinations that act like biological muscle and tendon, could also be used in prosthetic limbs. And we do have plans to extend our work into that realm in the near future.